Fizz is an amphibious yachter who dwells among the reefs surrounding beach water. He often retrieves and returns the tides cast into the sea by superstitious captains, but even the saltiest of sailors know better than to cross him. For many are the tales of those who have underestimated this slippery character. Often mistaken for some manner of capricious ocean spirit, he seems able to command the beasts of the deep and delights in confounding his allies and enemies alike. In ages past, the oceans of Runeterra were home to civilizations far older than those of the land. In the depths of what is now the Guardian Sea, a great city once stood. It was here that the Yordle Fizz made his home. He lived alongside the artisans and warriors of that proud noble race. Even though he was not one of them, they treated him as an equal, and his playful nature and tall tales of adventures in the open sea made him welcome at any gathering. But the world was changing. The oceans were growing warmer, emboldening fierce predators to rise up from the deepest trenches. Other settlements had fallen silent, but the rulers of the great city could still not agree on how to deal with the threat. Fizz pledged to roam the seas in search of survivors, or anyone who knew what had happened. Then, one dark night, the Gigalodons came. These huge dragon sharks stunned their prey with fell shrieking, and the avenues of Great City were soon clouded red. Thousands died in a matter of hours, the immense bulk of their killers crushing towers and temples in a monstrous feeding frenzy. Scenting blood in the water, Fizz raced back, determined to join the fight and save the city. He was too late. There was nothing left of the city to save. When the debris finally settled, not a single living creature remained, nor any stone upon another, and the ravenous shoal had moved on. Alone in the cold depths, Fizz sank into mournful despair. As his Yordle magic began to fade, he let himself be carried by the currents, drifting in a catatonic torpor, dreaming away the millennia. It was only a chance that reawakened him. A handful of copper coins fell from above, scattered to the seabed in the wake of a huge wooden fish that swam upon the surface. This was no Gigalodon, but Fizz was alarmed nonetheless. He knew little of the world overhead, but surely no fish could survive up there. He ventured up and peered into the salty air for the first time. There were people who lived outside of the water and sailed in wooden fish of all sizes. Fizz found the thought both frightening and exciting, but the curious gifts they cast into the water made it clear that they wanted to be his friends. In time, following their movements to and from across the oceans, he came to the port city of Bilgewater. To the inhabitants of that lawless place, this strange and slippery creature quickly became something of a legend, the tidal trickster, a spirit of the ocean itself. It is said that he can summon great beasts to do his bidding, hollow ships hull with stone trident and breathe air or water as it suits him. Many a misbehaving child has been warned on a moonless night, go quick to sleep or the trickster will come and feed you to the fishes. Fizz is good-natured but mischievous even for a Yordle, and delights in confounding the people of Bilgewater. The most seasoned fishermen know, just as the ocean may rise and fall, the tidal trickster is as likely to lead them into windless doldrums as to an easy catch that would fill their nests. Even so, Fizz does not take kindly to the greedy or selfish, and more than one Nautic sea captain hoping to make a quick pile of silver has found that her mysterious guide has led her crew not to safety, but to shipwreck. In the heart of Bilgewater, a salty tale awaits, spun by the raspy voice of old one-legged Lars. With a touch of caution and hint of foreboding, he takes us on a journey to a time when he faced the enigmatic ocean sprite known as Fizz, the tidal trickster. Perched on a rock amidst the treacherous, jagged straits, Lars found himself stranded after his ship met an untimely end, a story left for another night. As the sea's predator circled hungrily, a glimmer of pale eyes appeared, and Fizz emerged from the depths, a mysterious figure with a reputation that echoed beyond his playful demeanor. Lars clung to the rock, fear and curiosity intertwining as Fizz's presence repelled the circling shark. With a mix of unease and desperation, Lars plunged into the water, making his way to Bilgewater's shore. Yet, the trickster was an inescapable shadow, his watchful eyes following Lars as he sought refuge in a rat-infested inn. But Fizz's presence wasn't confined to the sea. He invaded Lars every moment, wreaking havoc and leaving wet footprints on the stairwell, a surreal reminder of his omnipresence. The trickster revealed in his role, gleefully tormenting Lars with seawater-laced porridge, tangled bootlaces, and slippery eels concealed in his bedding. Through the sinister pranks, Fizz's eerie laughter echoed, unsettling Lars' very soul. The suspense built until the breaking point when Lars confronted Fizz with a desperate plea. What do you want, you little monster? But answers were elusive. In the climactic night, the trickster's wet footfalls approached Lars' hiding place beneath the covers. Dread clenched Lars' heart as the footsteps ceased, followed by an eerie silence. The old sailor dared to peek from beneath his sanctuary, and to his astonishment found nothing but emptiness. Fizz had vanished, leaving behind only a gold kraken coin on Lars' wooden box. It was the same coin that their ill-fated captain had tossed into the ocean as an offering to the bearded lady for safe passage. It was that very coin that Fizz had taken, leading to the ship's demise. The coin, once a symbol of luck, now bore the weight of tragedy and malevolence. Lars' story serves as a haunting reminder of Fizz's true nature, a playful facade concealing a heart of darkness. The old sailor imparts his tale into a mixture of warning and solemnity, urging the young listeners to steer clear of the tidal trickster's path and hope to never encounter his watery tricks. As the night's tale comes to an end, one-legged Lars sends the young ones off to bed, urging them to watch for any damp footprints and to remember the story of Fizz. A reminder that even within the most whimsical tales, darkness may lie hidden, waiting for those brave enough to uncover it. And there you have it, dear lore lovers, the enthralling stories of Corki and Fizz, two champions whose destinies were etched in the vibrant tapestry of Runeterra. Whether soaring through the skies in a custom-designed gyrocopter or outwitting danger beneath the sea, their tales remind us that the League of Legends universe is a realm brimming with rich narratives and unforgettable characters. So, as you navigate through this world of magic and mayhem, remember the indomitable spirit of these champions and the adventures they bring to life. Thank you for joining us on this journey through lore. And until next time, may your curiosity continue to lead you to new and exciting tales.